Oh, no bias, no bull. Is President Obama making a dangerous mistake by closing Guantanamo, or is it more dangerous for the U.S. to keep it open? It's a question for our experts tonight. We've got Jed Babin, former Undersecretary of Defense for the first President Bush, a CNN national security analyst Peter Bergen with us once again, and Daily Beast website columnist Reza Aslan, who is also the author of No God But God, The Origins and Evolution and Future of Islam. Welcome, everybody. Peter, let me start with you, because you've actually been to the rehabilitation camps in Saudi Arabia where some of the Gitmo detainees go once they're released. I mean, give us your perspective here. I mean, can a jihadist be rehabilitated? It seems like an awfully big risk to take.
Well, certainly the Saudi government feels that way. So you can't really accuse the Saudi government of being soft on terrorism. They've killed something like 150 terrorists since 2003. They've incarcerated thousands of them. But they also believe that some people can be rehabilitated. And so this kind of rehabilitation program, you know, hundreds of people have gone through it. The Saudis say the recidivism rate is low. They've had 75 Guantanamo detainees who've gone through the program and been released. Obviously, this guy al-Shiri is an example of somebody who was lying, essentially. But the enemy of the perfect is not the reasonably okay. And I think that this rehabilitation program is a general proposition, which is also going on, by the way, in countries like Indonesia and Singapore, not only in Saudi Arabia, is a way to migrate people from violence to becoming members of the community. It's not perfect.
And just give us a little sense for what it entails, actually, Peter.
Well, surprisingly, you know, it's art therapy, which you don't normally think of in the same sentence as terrorism. But, you know, it's sitting down with psychologists, it's sitting down with clerics, it's you're in a prison, but it's a very comfortable prison. The people who go into the program are already out of a high security prison into something more like a campus situation where they have spent a lot of time talking to clerics who say, you know, your ideas about jihad are wrong, etc. You know, it's experimental. This program is not perfect, but it is one way to migrate people out of this jihadi path.
Jed, what do you make of this?
Well, I think it's a very optimistic and, quite frankly, not very reliable way to go. And Mr. al-Shiri is, according to my Pentagon sources, probably the 62nd person to be released from Guantanamo Bay to go back into the war. And we know at least 18 of them have been captured or killed since they went back to the battlefield. You have people who have to be kept in confinement for the rest of their lives because they're dead enders. There are some who can be rehabilitated. That's why we've released so many hundreds from Guantanamo Bay. But what we're seeing now with Barack Obama is the great disparity between campaign rhetoric and reality. He has an executive order that leaves all sorts of flexible room. He's going to make changes. He's going to change his mind, I hope, because I don't believe deep down he wants to hurt America. Closing that camp and letting these guys go is exactly the way to do that.
Reza, what do you think?
I think Jeb's making the same argument that's been made for the last 8 years and that it has proven woefully inadequate. I mean, the issue here isn't about what kind of possible short-term security gains we may or may not have by maintaining these prisoners in Guantanamo Bay. The issue is what kind of long-term security are we looking towards? And the fact of the matter is that the possibility of having a handful of these people go back to the battlefield and I'd say a lot of people in the intelligence community would question and have some skepticism about that number of 67. But regardless, well, having a number of these people out on the battlefield in and of itself is by no means, as Peter mentioned, an excuse to continue to absolutely damage, perhaps irreparably so, any hope of a long-term solution to a stable and secure relationship with the larger Arab world in the Middle East.
And Jed, you certainly heard the arguments. I mean, that these people can be tried and you know, held prisoner indefinitely in the United States. They don't have to be at Gitmo. And of course, the argument that it does more damage than good in terms of our reputation overseas.
What Aslan is saying is absolute nonsense. The people in the Pentagon who know about this stuff know these guys, some of them are dead enders. The issue is not creating some short-term or long-term issue here. The issue is the long-term problem that these guys are a danger. And we know that they're a danger, and we know they go back to the battlefield and kill people. I'd like to know who wants to stand next to the mother of a dead Marine who was killed by one of these guys.